today comes from John chapter 13, verses 1 to 17, and 31b to 35. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another."
Jesus washes his disciples' feet. Sometimes I think we have a clean and sanitized version of this act of servanthood from Jesus. Because here we have Jesus untying the shoes of the disciples' feet, taking off the socks. However, the disciples would have been wandering around in sandals, stepping over open sewers, dust, mud, so much more. Those feet would have seen some of the unpleasantness of the Middle East from 2,000 years ago. Here is the Son of God with a towel and a basin, washing the splashes of the open sewers, the mess of the road that is traversed by animals. God stepping into our world is God getting God's hands dirty, washing off the dust, the mud, the feces of the traveller's feet. Jesus shows leadership by lowering himself to do the job of what would have been done by a lowest of slaves. Jesus shows us how to be a leader by serving others, by washing his disciples' feet. Jesus shows us how to be a leader by dying on the cross for us. How are you prepared to show servant leadership? How are you prepared to follow the model of Jesus Christ? Today for the prayer, I actually want to read a prayer that is from history It's a prayer that St. Francis wrote. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is offense, let me bring pardon. Where there is discord, let me bring union. Where there is error, let me bring truth. Where there is doubt, let me bring faith. Where there is despair, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, let me bring your light. Where there is sadness, let me bring joy. O Master, let me not seek as much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that one receives. It is in self-forgetting that one finds. It is in pardoning that one is pardoned. It is in dying that one is raised to eternal life. Jesus washes his disciples' feet. He displays servant leadership, a model for us to follow. Amen. I